हेलो।
हेलो।
यस डॉक्टर शक्ति,
हेलो। या वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ
आफ्टरनून।
यू। विल स्टार्ट द सेशन विद इन 1 मिनट। डॉक्टर स्मृति मैम।
हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल?
या मैम, प्लीज स्टार्ट द सेशन मैम। डॉक्टर
हेलो,
स्मृति मैम, या यू आर ऑडिबल मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल मेंबर्स। ओके, नाउ आई वांट टू इनवाइट आई वांट टू वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर आवर 5 डेज फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम। इन टुडे इज अवर सेकंड डे ऑफ अवर प्रोग्राम। वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर अवर प्रोग्राम। नाउ आई इनवाइट स्पीकर मैम। सो ओवर टू यू सर।
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. A very good afternoon to all. So today is the second day of faculty development. This is going by Institute of Agricultural Sciences and Sports Department of Sage University, Indore. So second day, our speaker, Miss Lakshmi Bala, ma'am. About the ma'am, recently ma'am is working in a food engineering short college. Which is in on Prayagraj, Uttar Pradesh, as an assistant professor. About the ma'am, in 2002, madam qualified GRF from ICAR for admission in master's course. In 2010, madam qualified the NET exam of ICAR. And about the ma'am, she has public money. I would request you, ma'am, please start your session.
Okay, their audience, Miss, I mean, Kanjam.
Yeah, ma'am, please start your session.
Thank you very much, Dr. Shakti, for introducing me to the audience. And before I start my presentation by my lecture, my topic, let me thank the organizing committee for this 5 days faculty development program on this healthy food for healthy society, which is a very important topic in today's era. And also all the dignitaries and all the faculty members of Institute of Agriculture, Sciences and Sports Department, SAGE University. So I thank you all for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this event. And I really felt honored for this. And with this, words, without taking much time, I would like to proceed with my topic.
Okay. अरे वो सही, अरे वो साइड में ले ना.
If there is any query, I will give time. We'll have a very good time after this presentation, and we will discuss if there is any query, any difficulty. So I request to keep the mic mute.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Okay. In today's world. As a consumer, people, we have the mindset, we have the, stigma over processed food, that processed food are not good for health, processed food are not nutritious, and processed foods do not have any health benefits. But in today's, in my presentation today, with my background, with my understanding to the subject, and with my experiences, I would like to clarify this mindset, this conception that the processed food are not at all healthy, the processed food are bad, but in fact processed food are more nutritious and more healthy and more safe than the unprocessed food. So that is why I have taken up this topic based on the theme processed food reconcile towards the health, nutritional, and food security. So it finds some, to majority of the audience and to majority of the public, my topic may find contradictory, because I'm talking about processed food, and at the same time, I'm connecting processed food with the health, with the nutrition, and the food security. So with my presentation, I would like to justify that processed food are not at all bad, but in fact, they are more nutritious, more safe than the unprocessed foods. So these are some of the points which I may include in my presentation, in today's presentation. Okay, before proceeding, we need to understand what is processed foods. So processed food, the definition may be different or may be varied for different products. For example, when we talk about rice processing, when we talk about rice processing of the rice refers to the conversion of raw paddy into the edible form, which is white rice. So in this process, the processing step involves the removing of the husk, polishing of the bran layer, then we get the final product, which is white rice. Similarly, in case of wheat milling or wheat processing, we convert the wheat grain into very fine powder, in either in the refined form, refined flour, or in the whole flour. So the definition for the processing may differ from product to product, but in general, we can say the processed food, the processed food are the food that has been altered in some way during the preparation. So in my previous example, talking about paddy processing or wheat processing, during the processing step, we have altered the physical structure, or their somewhere, or the the properties of the product. So in this way, either fruits or vegetables, or meat or meat products, or cereal grains or oil seeds, there has been an alteration in the food during the process. So in this way, we can have a general definition that processed food are the food that has been altered in way during the preparation. Yeah, this one, this question, I think it's not visible. So the first and the foremost questions which come in our minds when we talk about the processed food is, are processed food safe? Or are processed food nutritious? So some people have the conception that processed food are generally thought to be inferior to the unprocessed food or the raw one. And sometimes the processed food. Processed food are sometimes assumed to be the cause of various health disorders like obesity epidemic, or like the cardiovascular diseases and the diabetic issues, which is the major health issue nowadays. So people have, correlate the processed food with the existing health issues. And some consumer have the mindset that processed food contains many ingredients, perhaps the use of artificial color, flavor, or other chemical additives. So here what I want to convey to my audience is processed food. The first point, that processed food are inferior to the unprocessed food. This is completely a misconceptualization. Processed food are not at all inferior to unprocessed food, but in fact, they are more safe and healthy. So this point I will justify in my coming slides. And second point, that the health issues like obesity or the cardiovascular diseases or diabetic issues, they are associated with the consumption of the processed food. But I object to this because consumption of the processed food is not the single issue which lead to these health issues. Obesity or any other heart disease diseases may, I mean, okay. So this may be due to, I mean, the main factor which is responsible for this type of health issue, we can relate with the unbalanced diet or oversized diet, or unbalanced, that is the amount of the food which we are consuming is not balanced with the physical activity which we are conducting. So the based on the lifestyle, we need to calculate the size of the plate, and anything in excess is obviously harmful to the health. Say if we use alcohol as a medicine, then it cures various diseases. It helps in the curation of the health issues. But if we are consuming alcohol in an indisciplined manner, without any discipline, so eventually it may lead to the health effects. Then the third point, that people speculation that the ingredients which are used in the processed food, they are not good for health. But to this point, what I want to make clear to the audience is, in food processing, we use certain additives. Additives may be in the form of, oh my God, I don't know why this is happening. Excuse me. So there are some additives which are I don't know why my slide is so these are used for various purposes, for that they are used purposely, but up to a limit. So the what are the limit that we can be used? I'm sorry for the inconvenience. I don't know why this is happening. Mm. Okay, so my answer is not all food are not all processed food is a bad choice. Through processing, we are able to convert the food, the raw material, into edible form, which is more acceptable to the consumer, which is more appealing, and which is more acceptable to the consumer. So that is one basic reason for the processing of the food. And third one, we can see here, taking the example of milk. Yeah, milk. If we take the example of milk, we use milk in our day-to-day life. In every house, we use milk on daily basis. But the source of milk are different. In some household, the source of milk is from the local milkman. And in some other household, the source of milk is from the retail shop, the processed milk, the packaged milk. So when we compare these two products, the unprocessed one, unprocessed meat, which we procure from the local milkman, and the one which we procure from the retail shop, there is a quite difference in the quality, because in the first one, from the local milkman, the quality is not assured. The quality and the safety of the milk is not assured, because the handling practices followed by the milkman while the rearing of the animal, or while milking the milk, while taking out the milk, say if the animal is not healthy, then the milk which we are consuming is also there are chances that it may lead to certain foodborne diseases. I mean, it may contain microorganisms which may affect the health of the consumer. And secondly, in case of local milkmen, the utensil they use for the collection of the milk, if they are not cleaned properly, if they are not washed properly, if they do not follow the hygienic practices, then it becomes the source of contamination. Then most importantly, the odor of the animal, the teeth of the animal from where we milk the milk, if it is not clean, so then that also become the point of contamination. Another important point in case of local or unprocessed milk is the environment. The environment in which the animal is being reared, and the environment in which the milking is being taken place. So if the environment is not clean, if the environment is not, the hygiene of the environment is not maintained, then obviously we all know the cow, the buffalo, they are surrounded by cow dungs, their waste material, the grasses, the feed we feed to the animals. So we can imagine the cow dung, the waste, the urine, the excreta of the animal, they are the biggest source of microorganism. So in this case, if the milkman, the local milkman, if they do not follow proper hygiene and the sanitary practices, then this lead to the contamination. And if we are using that milk, then it become lead to the health issue. But in case of the processed milk, all the safety and the hygiene requirements are taken into consideration. So it is safe from all the disease-causing microorganisms. I'm so sorry for the inconveniences from my side, the slide. Okay, so I will keep this slide like this for time being, because it's been so sensitive. I don't know why it is moving by its own.
No issue, ma'am. Please, please.
Now, coming to the food industry in India, the contribution of food industry in India. So, talking about India, we all know our country is a diverse country. Diversity not only in term of culture, not only in term of cultural diversity, but in term of climatic diversity. We can experience the almost all the climatic condition in our this thing, country. In the northern region, we experience a cold climate, the Himalayan ranges, and in the southern region, the peninsula region, the climatic condition is different. And in the coming to the northeastern part of India, we experience heavy rainfall. And on the western part of India and in the central part of India, the climatic conditions are completely different. And at the same time, the in our country, the almost all the there are different soil types. And in India, we can find maximum of the soil types. So this, diversity in the vegetation, diversity in the soil type. So this favor supports the growth of it's in every crop type. So in India, we can find it's in every crop type, and the production is also quite high. So the production wise, this can be verified from the survey of India. That in terms of fruits and vegetable production, India ranks in the globally. I'm talking about globally. So globally, India stands in the second position next to China. So in this way, like other crop, India is in the top rank. And similarly for the this thing. Fish and the marine products. So the coastal line, our coastal line, we can So my point is, because we are so blessed by different climatic conditions, we are so blessed by the different soil type. So and the in this way, the production is quite high. And globally, all over the world, and in terms of meat and fish and marine product, also consider we can imagine the coastal line starting from Maharashtra till extending till the Bay of Bengal. So this much magnitude of the coastal line. So the production of the fish and the marine product is also, in the top ranking. But The irony is, the saddest part is, even though the production is quite high, we are not able to feed the whole of the population. More than half, almost half of the population is below the poverty line. We are not able to give two square meal a day. Food, which is the basic need. We are talking about health, we are talking about nutrition. But when they do not get the meal, food, when they do not receive the meal, how can we talk about their health? How can we talk about their nutrition, the health? I don't know what is happening. I'm so sorry. So this is the irony, that even though the production is very high, but we are not able to provide food to to all the individual, all the population in our country. So what is the reason behind? the production is high, but still we are not able to provide food to each and every individual. So what is the reason? The reason is very briefly, the reason is due to improper post harvest management practices, which lead to the losses, the high amount of losses after during the post harvest management. So with time, with the advancement in the technology, various studies and the researches are going on that to improve the to reduce the losses, post harvest losses, and then we can bridge the gap between the production, and we can be able to feed each and every individual. So this can be achieved through proper post-harvest management. And proper post-harvest management include processing of the food, because fruits and vegetables and every majority of the crop, they are perishable in nature, and hence since they are perishable, their shelf life is very less. So to preserve the food without losing its nutritional quality, retaining its nutritional importance, so this can be done through food processing. So in this way, it's gone somewhere else. I don't know. I have deleted by mistake. So this is in this way, the contribution of the food industry is very large to overcome these challenges. And we can have some of the advantages of processed food. In our day-to-day life, we have been hearing about all the bads of the food processing, but through this webinar, I try to put before the audience some of the plus points of a processed food. So number one, processed food. I don't know why this is happening. Dr. Shakti, is this from my side or I don't know?
Yes, ma'am, please.
Okay. I will still continue to explain. I don't need to put the slide also. So first advantage is, for the audience, I have just put up this point. It reduces the bacteria, food infection. Food infection, it is wrong to use the term infection alone here, because there are many foodborne diseases. So diseases which are caused by the consumption of the contaminated food. So foodborne diseases can be of two types, can be classified into two major types. Number one, food poisoning or food intoxication, and number two, food infection. So the first one, food poisoning or food intoxication, this happens when the food is already spoiled outside the body. So the spoiled food, contains the toxins which are produced by the harmful microorganisms. So because of which, when we consume that spoiled food, the toxin, it goes inside our body, and it causes various health issues. And that is termed as food poisoning or food intoxication. Whereas the second one, food infection, this is because it happens when we consume food which has harmful microorganisms in it. The microorganism has not spoiled the food yet, but the food they reside on the microorganism, they reside on the food, and it goes into the body. The microorganism goes into the body along with the food, and inside the body they multiply, they grow, and hence they produces metabolites which are not suitable for our body environment, and that is known as food infection. So this happens when we consume unhygienic or unsafe food, but through food processing, this problem can be eliminated. So the food, the processed food are safe from foodborne diseases. This is first advantage. Second advantage, number two, it stay fresh for a long time. Stay fresh for a long time. Why? Because there are some factors which lead to the spoilage of food. I don't know, because we are from different backgrounds, so I mean, the many may not be, some may be aware of it, but here briefly I would like to say some of the factors which are responsible for the spoilage of the agricultural produces, whether fresh or the cooked one. So those parameters are the moisture content in the food, then oxygen, O2, temperature, relative humidity, then biological factors, and then the nature of the food itself. Nature of the food itself, because some food may be acidic, some may be non-acidic. So based on that, I don't know what is happening with my slide. So wherever moisture content is high, where moisture content, the amount of the water present in this thing, the food is termed as moisture content. So wherever moisture content is high, there are chances for the this thing. There are chances for okay, no problem. So there are chances that the food gets spoiled, because moisture, it favors the it become favorable for the microorganism wherever excess moisture is present. So by the use of advanced technologies, we can have control over these parameters, that is water moisture content, oxygen, and then the temperature of the environment. So this is one advantage of food processing. Through food processing, we can control, we can have control over these parameters which are responsible for the spoilage of the food, and we can make the food stay fresh for a longer time. So next slide, in this slide, I would like to elaborate about the objectives of food processing. Why do we process food? So the objective of some of the objectives of food processing may be listed as number one, it increases the availability and convenience. So how can we, justify to this point? Because it increases availability. That means because the point of production, the point of production of the crop is not the point of utilization. For example, apple is grown in cold regions like the Himalayan ranges. But we can enjoy apple in almost every part of the country. So, and at the same time, apple, which is a perishable crop, perishable means moisture content, whose moisture content is high, we term it perishable. So apple is a perishable crop. So because of, yes, am I not audible?
Yes, your voice was cracking, ma'am, in between. Now it's audible.
Okay, maybe technical problem. So it increased the availability, but means the point of production is not the point of utilization, but through food processing we can enjoy every food in every part of the region of the country. Then second point, I don't know why this is happening. This is happening for the first time. I don't know why. My slides are doing. Dr. Shakti, क्या कल भी ऐसे हुआ था क्या?
No ma'am, no ma'am.
But I don't know why this is happening.
Ma'am, stop sharing and share it again. Maybe your problem will resolve.
Yeah, it may be. Thank you. I will try it. Yeah. So where I was in the first point. Increasing the availability, so the point, and at the same time, this thing, convenience. For example, Amul milk. I'm not promoting any brand. That is not my intention. This is to make clear. Is my screen visible? Abhi nahi hoga na?
Not now, ma'am.
Your screen is not visible.
Yes, let me. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Tia is requesting remote control of your screen. Who is Tia? This is the issue. I was doing clicking approve. That is why this was happening. I think so. So this time I will decline.
I would request to you, Tia, please.
Yes, second, okay. I was talking about the conveniences of the this thing, the processed food. So taking example of Amul milk. So my intention is not to promote any brand here. My intention is to communicate with the audience. So with example, we understand better. So that is why I'm taking the example of Amul. So Amul, we all know, we don't Amul franchises, Amul plant, it is not available in any in every district or every part of the country, but we are this thing enjoying the flavor of Amul in every part of the country. So the transportation, so transportation requires proper transportation facilities. So through processing, so this is one the example of the objective of the processed food. Similarly there are many foods. Then second point is ensuring food safety. So the processed food, it ensure to the consumer that the food we are consuming is safe. it is safe from disease causing microorganisms. So the certification on the package, the logo on the certification, logo on the packages and other information given on the package, those are all legal things. So if there is any deviation, between the information which is given on the package and the actual, the quality of the product or the content inside the package. So if there is any deviation, the producer or the processor has to face the consequences in a legal fashion. So in today's time, we can cross-check the quality. Any individual, any consumer has the right to check the quality of the product. So in this way, the food processor, they are very much cautious about this fact. That is why the safety and the quality of the food product is of top concern, is of key concern. So in this way, we can assure that the processed food are safe, unlike the unprocessed one. Maine example liya tha local milkman, the milk which we procure from the local milkman. So there is no any assurance that the handling and the milking process, the process of rearing the animal, they are hygienic or they follow the sanitary practices. Who is going to give us the verification? So there is no any assurance in such type of unprocessed food, but the processed one, yes, they are assured. Then the third one, personalized nutrition and the health, or in other words, we can say customize. We can customize our diet. We can customize the food through processing. Again, for your easy understanding, for our easy communication, I will take the example of milk again here, because milk is one of the common food which we consume in every day in every household. So the customization on the through the processed food. So talking about the milk in market, in retail shop, we can find different type of liquid milk. We have the standardized liquid milk in market. So the term standardization means the parameter in the product has been altered. So in case of standardized milk, the fat content of the milk is altered or has been maintain the fat content in the milk as per the requirement to the consumer. For example, we can find full cream milk. We have toned milk, we have double toned milk. So the fat content for these milks, for these three different standardized milk, they are different. For the full cream, on an average, the standard the fat content may be up to 6%. For toned milk, the fat content may be up to 3%, and for the standard double tone, the fat content, it may be up to 1.5%. So for the different individual, for different consumer, they can select the type of the milk which is suitable for their body, which is suitable for their diet. So in the similar manner for other food product also, through processing, we can customize the nutritional and the content of the product. Another example, which is very common nowadays, we can take the example of lactose, alteration in the amount of lactose in milk. We all know lactose is milk sugar, which is made up of two units of sugar, that which are glucose and galactose. So for some diabetic patient, they would like to, prefer milk which are less in lactose content, less in sugar content. So for those group of consumer, the separation of the lactose from the milk is carried out, thus reduces the sugar content in the milk. So that is an example, also an example of customized or personalized food through processing. Then the next one, this one, fortification and enrichment. So these are very important terms in food processing: fortification and enrichment, which involve the addition of the targeted nutrients in the food after processing or during processing. But there is a slight difference between these two terms. So what is the difference? The first one, fortification. Fortification, in the process of fortification, we add the specific nutrient to the food, which is not the origin of that source. That means this nutrients which was not present in the raw material earlier, but after through processing we have added intentionally that specific nutrient. Example, iodized salt or fortified rice, rice fortified with iron. So we all know iodized number, there are number of deficiency diseases, goiter, or which is one of the deficiency diseases due to deficiency of iodine in the body. So to supplement the iodine requirement in the body, we fortify the salt with iodine. So the fortification is a very vast topic. Dr. Shakti?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see my screen?
Yeah, it's visible, ma'am.
Yeah, but can you see some additional emoji on my screen?
Yes, yes.
What can you see?
Recently, you are describing about fortification and enrichment.
Yes, ma'am.
No, emoji. Can you see the heart shaped hearts, little hearts on my screen? Who has done this? This is an indisciplinary manner. We are all educated. We are attending a webinar. Who is this participant? Can you figure it out?
I would request to all participants, please stop.
Is this
screen.
The way? You can see. Can you see these hearts on my screen?
I would request to all, please don't share anything. Ma'am, please continue.
So fortification itself is a very vast topic, which is a part of food processing, and which food to be selected for which type of nutrient to fortify. So that we have to be very specific, and we have to analyze this. For example, in case of goiter, because goiter disease is irrespective of gender, it can be to a female or it can be to male, or it is irrespective of the age. That is, goiter can be anyone in any age group, either kids or adult or anyone can be suffer from this disease. So we have to select that food which is common to each and every community, it's in every group or population. So salt is one example for such type of food. Food, because we use salt in every the dishes we prepare. So for the iodine fortification, we select salt. Similarly, for the fortification of iron deficiency anemia, we can see this is common mostly in female. due to the biological processes, I mean the person infected, who are suffering from the anemia, they mostly belong to female. So in this way, we have to select that food which is more common to female. So that is why we don't use salt for this. We don't select salt for the fortification of iron, but in fact we select rice for the fortification of iron. So in this fashion, we do fortification and we improve the nutritional value of the food. So this is one objective of food processing. Then second one, enrichment. So enrichment again is also this addition of the specific nutrient in the food, but this takes place, this is carried out after the food is being processed, after processing, because during processing at the particular processing step, there are chances that some of the nutrients may get lost. For example, in the processing of fruits and vegetables, when they are exposed to high temperature, thermal processing. So during this processing, when the food are exposed to high temperature, some of the heat sensitive nutrients like vitamins, they get lost. So at the end of processing, the amount of the vitamin content is reduced as compared to the raw material. So at the end, we incorporate the calculated amount of the nutrient or the vitamin lost during the process so that it can balance the desirable vitamin in the product. So in this way, nutritional component can be enriched after processing. And here, this is carried out when some of the nutrients are lost as a result of during the processing. So this fortification and enrichment in this way, these are again the two objectives for the processing of food. The last one, preserving the quality. Preserving the quality, this is very important. Quality, when I say quality, we cannot define quality in a single term. The definition of the quality will differ from end users, E-N-D-N, end users to end users. Well, because for a food nutritionist, For a food nutritionist, he or she will call a food a good quality food when it has the good nutritional composition in it. And for a food processor, a good quality means, I mean, in terms of milling quality, the hardness, the texture, the various properties, physical properties, engineering properties, etc. And for a plant breeder, to grow the plant for a breeder, a good quality seed or great seed, maybe, I mean, which has a high percent, viability, he will count quality in term of viability. So the percentage of germinated seed for him is of good quality. So, but as a food processor here, the quality I would like to refer to is the overall quality, the nutritional quality, the texture of the food, textural parameters, quality of the food, the sensory quality of the food, the taste, flavor, overall acceptability, so on. So through food processing, we can preserve the quality. One. So this is very important to preserve the nutritional quality, to preserve the sensory quality, to preserve the textural quality of the food product for a very long time. Is very important because the time of production is not the time of consumption, because every crop, they are seasonal. Most of the majority of the crop, fruits and vegetables, cereal grains, they are seasonal. So during the season, the production is very high. and we do not consume it immediately. For example, paddy. During the season, we harvest paddy and the production is in surplus. And we do not consume paddy immediately after harvesting. So we have to keep the paddy for the future use, for use in the off season. Similarly for other fruits and vegetables as well. So how to preserve it? Preservation means we have to maintain the quality. We have to all the nutritional components in the food need to be retained. The color need to be retained. So how can we achieve this? So this can be done through the processing of food. So these are some of the major objectives of food processing. Why it is not moving? Slides shared. So there are some facts and the myth about the processed food. So the first myth is processed food offer no benefit, which is untrue, because processed food make the alternative food. We can get variety of food through processing. We can get quality food. We can get safe food. So it has lots of health benefits and other distinct practical benefits in our day-to-day life. Then second myth is processed food are not nutritious as fresh food. But processed food are in fact more nutritious than the unprocessed food, depending upon the way in which we are processing. Then the third myth, I have put up this point in my previous slide also, the use of additives. So additives are those substances which we intentionally put in the product during the preparation with various objectives. Either to preserve it in the form of preservative, to improve the color in the form of colorant, or as a flavor enhancer, or as an emulsifier, we use different additives. But what is the limit? How much, what is the permissible limit that can be used for food? So that has been prescribed legally. So if we are using within the limit, then it will not cause any harmful effect to our body. But if we are using beyond the limit, then obviously it will cause harm to our health. And this is monitored by various official authorities. So whether the food processor, they are within the limit, they are following the legal requirements in terms of the additives they are using. So these are monitored and observed by the concerned authorities. Now, I was talking about many times, I have told you in my presentation since the beginning that in processed food, quality and the safety are of key concern. So how do we control this quality? How do we manage the safety of the processed food? Let me share a few points about the quality control and the safety of the processed food. So quality control and the safety, this is controlled by the authority. The authority which is responsible for monitoring the safety and the quality of the food in our country, India, is governed by Food Safety Standard Authority of India. आप लोगों ने सुना होगा बहुत अब यू मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ इट FSSAI फूड सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया विच इज द ऑफिशियल हेडक्वार्टर इज इन गुड़गांव. So under the Food Safety Act 2006, the Food Safety Standard Authority of India controls over the quality and the safety of the food. the quality and the safety of the food, of the processed food, has to meet even at the standard. We have to meet this international standard, because we all know our country, because of the blessed climatic condition, vegetation, the production is quite high. This is in term of raw or the fresh crops, but in term of processed food, the contribution is very less because of the poor quality processed food. We are not able to compete in the international market. So to rectify this, with reference to the World Trade Organization, the FSSI also holds over the control of the quality and the safety of the food with respect to the international standard. We need to meet the international standard so that we can compete, our processed food can compete with the quality of the international market. So FSSAI is responsible, is the authority, official authority responsible for monitoring of the quality and control. So in this way, FSSAI, issue license. आप देख सकते हो, nowadays कोई भी processed food check in package, we can find FSSAI license. So the any food processor, any business, if you are any entrepreneur, if you are setting up a food process product plan, first we need to get license from FSSAI, and during the licensing we have to fulfill all the legal requirements, and in between there will be auditing, there will be monitoring, and the quality audit will be a continuous process once the licensing is done. So licensing can be different types, depending upon the business type, the turnover, less than 12 lakhs, between 12 lakhs to 20 crore, or which are above 20 crore. For this different condition, there are different clauses for the registration and the licensing procedure. So once it is complete, once it is fulfilled, the FSSAI will issue license for that product, and then we can assure that the product with the FSSAI license is safe and the quality is being consistently monitored. So to make clear to my audience, I have a few of these pictures to show, the FS, here we can see, I will highlight, for this product we can see the FSSAI license number. Then for this product we can see the FSSAI license product, and similarly, this has been hidden. So similarly, आप कोई भी product उठा लीजिए randomly market से, we will find this FSSAI license number. And while licensing, let me try to clarify one more point. Say Nestle company manufacture this thing. Nestle company manufacture Maggie. So, but we can see, but Nestle has different branches. One at Moga, Punjab, Pantnagar, Uttarakhand, then Himachal Pradesh. So in this way, there are different, plants for Nestle which manufacture Maggi. But for the FSSAI licensing for different location for different plant for different product for a specific product, we need to take license separately. So in this it is clear to us that even the product is same, but these are being prepared, these are being manufactured at different location, hence their license number will also be different. So the quality control in food industry, quality control of the processed food in food industry. So one of the rational and the logical approach towards quality control of processed food in food industry is ISACCP. ISACCP, or in otherwise it is pronounced as HACCP. The full form for ISACCP, S stands for hazard, A stands for analysis, C for critical control point. Hazard analysis critical control point. So this is through this approach towards the quality control, we identify the possible hazards. There are three possible hazards: physical hazard, chemical hazard, chemical hazard and biological hazard. So physical hazard, for example, the presence of physical material like metal pieces or glass pieces, papers, or anything physical, which may cause harmful effect to our health. Chemical, maybe the detergent which we use or the chemical which we use for the cleaning purposes. Cleaning agents, etc., biological, microorganisms. So in every step, we try to figure out the possible hazard, physical, chemical, and biological. And we analyze what may be the consequences of the presence of this hazard, whether what will be the severity if they are present to our health, whether it may cause just a mild fever or vomiting, or it may lead to operational diseases, or it may lead to the fatal or the death of the consumer. So in this way, we try to figure out find out the hazard, possible hazard, and analyze it, and we decide the critical limits. Matlab, like for example, lubricating oil. In food processing, we use processing equipments. So processing equipments, for some equipment, we use motor, which comes in direct contact with the food. So in that case, if the equipment is not designed hygienically, the oil may leak, there may be leakage of the oil, and the oil may come into the food. So what is the limit in that case? We body can tolerate, it is acceptable, permissible, and beyond this limit, it can be considered as a hazard. So we decide the critical limit for each and every parameters, whether physical parameters, or chemical parameters or biological parameters? Any microorganism just the consumable of this journey, we the chances for the presence of this hazard are maximum. So through SSCCP, we try to prevent or we try to eliminate the presence of the possible hazards at different points. And in this way, this has become a very successful, very scientific and logical approach towards the control of the quality in processed food. So we need to know the brief history of the SSCCP because this is very important. In the year 1960s, the astronaut, I mean, for the NASA, National Aeronautic and Space Administration, they were developing space foods. Space food means food they have to provide for the astronauts in the space. So we can imagine space food should, I mean, the quality should be 100%. I mean, assurance. So they were doing research on the space food, the quality and the safety of the space food, and with the collaboration with this company Pillsbury, they were developing food for the astronaut. And through this process, during this process, they adopted the process, the initial stage of SSCCP, and that was, come out to be a successful approach. So since then, after the successful effort by the Pillsbury company and in association with the NASA, so this SSCCP has now implemented in every food industry as a systematic approach for the control of the food. So this is very important as a SSCP, which we all need to know, because from whatever background we are, chahe aap engineer ho, chahe aap physical education ho, chahe aap biologist or chemist or anyone or artist, anyone, for us, food is common to us. So safety and the quality of the food is important for every individual. So this is our basic fundamental need that we should know about the background of the quality and the control system in the food industry. So another example of quality and the safety food, DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization, Government of India. Ministry of Defense. So DRDO also established several laboratories in which they undergo research and development for the quality and the safety, safe food for to provide to our defense services personnel, for Indian Army, for the Navy, for the paramilitary forces. So for our defense personnel, their health, their fitness is of top priority. If they are not healthy, if they are not fit, then how can, be able to sustain, survive themselves in very adverse condition. So to provide a good quality food, to provide safe food anywhere, any place, whether inside the jungle or at the at the high altitude of the Himalayan ranges, we have to provide good food to them. Good food means quality and the safe food. So with this perspective, the RDO has established different and they have developed a number of processed food for the Army, Navy, Air Force. So my point is, when such highly sensitive forces like the astronaut defense services, they are relying on processed food. Then why not we, the common men? Why we have the mindset that processed food are not good, processed food are not healthy? Why this mindset? So this is the, my objective for today's presentation based on the topic of this webinar of this faculty development program. So in this way, processed food, they are, the major source of safe and quality food for the astronaut, for the space, as well as for the defense personnel. I have a list of the food which are developed by DRDO. So maybe I can share it after this slide presentation. So for our common men, for the general consumer, there are different categories of processed food. Number one, we can understand minimally processed food. Minimally processed food are those food which has undergone slight processing, like in terms of trimming, that is removing or removal of the these unwanted parts of the plant or the crop, or size reduction for convenient use, because nowadays in every household, all the the women are working women. So we have to manage our time, and at the same time we cannot compromise with our health. So to balance the workplace and the health and the family, so this type of processed food, minimally processed food, which are available in supermarket in every part of the country, so we they are ready to use, and at the same time the quality and the freshness of the product of the vegetables and the fruit will retain through the advanced technologies adopted during the processing. So minimally processed food, so the use of the vacuum packaging, see, we can see here vacuum packaging, the packaging techniques used are the vacuum packaging. And vacuum means, all the airs are sucked out, and air, oxygen, which is one parameter for the spoilage of the food. So if it is eliminated from the environment, so it could become safe. So this, we can have, a different webinar or different seminar on the classification of the food. This is a very vast topic, but for time being, we need to understand that minimally processed food are, the food that has been undergone through minimal processing, like removing of the unwanted parts or the reduction of the size for the convenient use or to the customer or to the consumer. Meat and fish, they are very sensitive to microbial microorganisms. So if they are not processed properly, if they are not handled properly, then it becomes the source for microbial contamination. In local market, we can see the vendor, the shopkeepers, the retailers, handle the meat and the fishes, which are highly perishable. So sometimes it is cannot be accepted. But the processed one, the quality is maintained and they are free from any microorganisms. And talking about eggs, we cannot ignore eggs. The hygienic and the sanitary practices of handling eggs, because when the bird lays eggs, on the surface of the egg, most of the time we can find the animal fecal blood on the egg, and if this is not clean or washed or hygienically, then if we get into the kitchen directly or into the refrigerator directly, then this is the biggest source for the microbial contamination, like salmonella. सो पूरा आपका किचन आपका रेफ्रिजरेटर विल गेट कंटामिन क्रॉस कंटामिनेटेड विद सेल्मोनेला एंड अदर similar kind of microorganisms. But the processed one, the processed egg, they are completely sanitized, they are completely free from all these food, harmful microorganisms. Processed milk. In the beginning also I have given the example of processed milk in term of standardized milk, that is the amount based on the amount of the fat content, the amount of the lactose content, the consumer preference, they can select milk of their choice. And apart from the fat content and the sugar content, one very advantage of the processed food is the tetra packaging or tetra pack milk. These are aseptically packaged. आप लोगों ने सुना होगा एसेप्टिक दिस आर प्रोसेस टू एसेप्टिक प्रोसेसिंग एसेप्टिक प्रोसेसिंग मीन्स द पैकेजिंग मटेरियल आर स्टेराइल स्टेराइल पैकेजिंग मटेरियल and the sterile milk, and they are packed in the sterile condition. And the aseptically processed milk, they are self-stable. Self-stable means for storage, it doesn't require any refrigeration. बाकी जो आप रिटेल शॉप में जो पाउच वाली मिल्क लिक्विड मिल्क वी नीड टू स्टोर अंडर स्पेसिफिक कंडीशन दैट ambient condition for 3 to 4 months or even more 6 months. So this is the advantage of processing, that easy handling and the storage. आप कहीं पे भी ले जा सकते हैं tetra pack without any refrigeration. So the quality will will retain. Canned foods. So canned foods, the meat and the meat products which we provide to the defense personnel to keep them fit, to keep them healthy. They are mostly in the form of canned foods. So canned food can be meat and meat products or any cereal or pulses or legumes or fruits and vegetables. So any food can be processed through canning, and this is again a self-stable food until and unless the package is open. So in the undisturbed condition we can store we can keep the food for a very long time, up to 3 months, 4 months. Dehydrated fruits and vegetables. So dehydration is one way of preserving the food by reducing the water activity. The water activity means by removal of water. So in food, I have told in my early slide that water or moisture content in the food is one of the culprit of food spoilers. So if we reduce this water, then it become unfavorable for the microorganism to grow. And in this way, we can keep the food for a very long time. And dehydration, drying and dehydration, we all know this is the most oldest technique of food preservation. If we go back to history, in earlier days, since time immemorial, drying and dehydration has been the preservation technique. But with time, in those days, the drying medium was only the solar drying, sun drying. And with time, with the development of the mechanical dryers, things become easy and convenient, and we don't have to depend on the climatic condition But among the mechanical dryer also, there are different types of dryers. So we have to select the suitable one. And in current scenario, the best, I mean, we are talking about quality and the nutritional importance or value of the food. So during drying by mechanical dryer, sometime when we expose to the drying medium, which is usually hot air, so the heat sensitive vitamins and the color get lost. So the alternative, the advanced technique like freeze drying, it retains the heat sensitive nutrients in the food, it retains the quality, the color in the food, and it retains the texture in the food. So comparatively, the freeze dryer has advantage over the other, but the operational cost will be higher comparatively. So we have to use freeze dryer for very selective or specific crop type with depending on their market value and the consumer demand. So these are again some of the freeze dried product, the bitter gourd, and then pumpkin. We can see even after drying the color is still retained. So these are also dehydrated corn by using freeze dryer. So freeze dryer, we can see the greenness, maybe because of my picture resolution, the color may be light, but in actual, the color of the freeze dried products, not only this product, but almost all the product, the color is retained. So this is freeze dried strawberry, freeze dried apple. So the courtesy of this picture, this is from one of the freeze dryer manufacturer. So they provided me these pictures, but in actual, yes, freeze dried products, they have superior quality over the other. The dragon fruit dried of the processed food is baby food, the infant foods. So infant food means we have to be very sensitive. We need to check out the nutritional requirement for the infant. So how much, what is the nutritional requirement, and what are the raw material which can be used for the preparation of the infant food. So all these things, these are monitored and handled by the Indian BIS, Bureau of Indian Standardization. So the draft prepared by the Bureau of Indian Standardization include all the legal requirements for the development of baby foods. Then value addition of products. So through food processing, we can add value to the product. For example, fruits like guava, Allahabad. Since we belong to Allahabad is famous for guava. And guava, we have different varieties of guava, superior variety like Allahabad Safeda, and we have inferior variety of guava. So in market, people, the consumer, they always prefer the superior variety and they neglected the inferior variety guava. But the difference may be in terms of their looks, their appearance. The superior one look good, the inferior one doesn't look good. Appearance is the first impression, which is the human tendency. There is nothing to debate about it. So consumer, they prefer the good quality, good look, Allahabad Safeda, and neglect the inferior one, which doesn't look good. But the nutritional value of both the guava are almost the same. So why then, फिर क्या होगा जो superior, inferior variety guava है, क्या हम उसको फेंकेंगे? No. So we can add value to it. We can develop a product out of it which is more appealing and which is more acceptable to the consumer, like the preparation of jam and jelly. out of the inferior quality guava, and we can this thing other items out of, and many research even in our department also we have carried out number of research on the value addition of the inferior or underutilized crops including guava. And most importantly for kids, for the children, they usually they stay away from fruits and vegetables, but like for example beetroot and star fruits, they are highly nutritious not only for adult but children but also for the adults. So star fruit, experience wise, in our personal experiences, it has proven that the diabetic patient who she or he is consuming star fruit on daily on regular basis, their health is improving. So to make them available to the children and to every population, we develop very number of value added product out of this fruits and vegetable, and that is one perspective objective of food processing. Then some of the grains like millets, आप लोगों ने, बहुत सारे लोगों ने तो नहीं देखा होगा, बच्चे जो न्यू जेनरेशन है, आई मीन बाय वीक दे कैन, जैसे हम पैडी, इफ वी सी पैडी, इफ वी सी राइस, वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई इजीली, इफ वी सी व्हीट ग्रेन, वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई इजीली, बट इफ वी ब्रिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मिलेट इन फ्रंट, दे कैन नॉट आइडेंटिफाई. दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द लैक ऑफ अवेयरनेस. बट मिलेट, दिस आर the nutri grains, NUTRI nutrients, because the nutritional composition of the millets are very high. So even we can have a separate discussion on millet or separate seminar. So to make available to the consumer, to make people aware of the millets, we develop value added products out of it. And let me tell you to my audience, this is the golden opportunity, because I'm emotionally connected with millets, because these are neglected crops. But the advantages of millets are, I mean, they can grow under adverse environmental conditions. Like nowadays we are facing global warming, the temperature is increasing, and which is not suitable for every crop type. They are not able to tolerate the increasing temperature, but the millets, they can grow under adverse temperature, they can grow under a very poor soil condition. So why should not we take this priority to this type of crop, and at the same time they have very high nutritional value. So this we need to focus on the millets. Underutilized crop which are not grown commercially, but with the ever increasing population, we have to, I think I'm taking very much longer time, so I will just try to be fast. I'm completing it fast. So but yes, one of the objective of this thing food processing is the utilization of the underutilized crops, those crops which are not grown commercially but are found abundantly in wild, but they have the same nutritional value, because population is increasing day by day and the cultivable area land size is shrinking with the increase in urbanization. Jaise population badhega to we have to construct houses, we have to construct buildings, residential areas. So in this way the land size for the agriculture is reducing, shrinking. So we cannot depend then rely or confine only on the cultivable crops, but we need to explore more, we need to go for the underutilized crop, and we have to take benefit out of it. So this is wild variety walnut. आप लोगों ने नहीं देखा होगा. Any audience, आप में से किसी ने देखा है ये wild walnut anywhere? I hope नहीं देखा होगा. सो दिस इज द इंटरनल दिस थिंग कर्नल ऑफ द वॉलनट एंड दिस हैज ऑयल कंटेंट ऑफ अप्रोक्सीमेटली ऑन एन एवरेज 63-64% ऑयल. सो व्हाई डोंट व्हाई शुड नॉट बी यूटिलाइज दिस एंड अदर processing like the byproduct utilization in rice milling. Rice bran is one byproduct. So byproduct means from which we can prepare secondary product out of it. So imagine in our country, rice milling has the largest contribution in food industry. Rice industry has the largest contribution. So on daily basis, tons and tons of paddy are being milled. So the imagine the amount of the rice bran which is producing on daily basis. So kahan phenkenge hum, how to utilize it? Waste management is also a very big issue. So rice bran has a very high oil content, up to on an average of 13-14%. So this can be used as a source of edible oil. Similarly, for dairy products, after cheese preparation, after paneer preparation, the liquid fraction which is wasted, they are known as whey, and we can use it for the development of byproduct or for the isolation of protein out of the whey and so on. Similarly, the solid part of the fruits and vegetable after juice is extracted, that is known as pomace. So they are very rich in nutrients. They are very high fiber content. So instead of wasting, instead of discarding, we can produce. So right, how to select process for you to listen? We need to read the label. All the information are given on the label, and about the raw material use, about the product, then the expiry date. So we need to read it carefully. And all the information in process one, convenience to the consumer, ready to eat food. Market se leke aao, if you do not have time, then we can just heat it up in the microwave, then we can consume it anytime. And since we are in the hustle and the bustle of the life, everyone is very busy. Even for the students who are staying out of the home, they cannot compromise with their health. So they have limited infrastructure. So this will make convenience for each and we have to limit to the type of the fat. Saturated and unsaturated. Unsaturated are good one, saturated are bad one. So if we are consuming more of the saturated fat, they are solid under this thing, room temperature. So they may accumulate in the interior of the arteries and may lead to blockage or various cardiovascular diseases.
Voice is not clear.
Yes, we cut. I get disconnected. So in this way, while selecting the food processor, when they formulate the food type, the amount of the sugar they use, the amount of the fat they use, we do not have control over it. But we can choose, we can select the food processed food by our choice. So while choosing or while selecting the processed food, we have to read the label carefully. And then the information given on the nutritional information given on the label. So in this way, we can select the suitable food for our body. So lastly, I would like to say that the key to healthy eating starts with oneself. And most importantly, eat right, not less. So to make themselves fit, they take very less diet, which lead to starvation. That is not fitness, that is starvation. Yes, no problem, obesity or the body, metabolism, this differ from person to person, individual to individual. It may be because of the genetic factor, or it may be because of the some other health issues like thyroid, etc. But the most important part from our side, which we can do, is to balance the amount of the food we consume and the activity which we perform. And we have to take calculated amount of the plate size. So eating is not the problem. Overeating or unbalanced eating is the issue, is the main reason which lead to unhealthy or unfit life. So with this note, I would like to wind up my presentation. Yeah? Naito, I'm taking very long time. I think it now abhi pone 5 ho gaya. So thank you so much. Now I open this forum to the audience if they want to ask any question. And if there is any suggestion, ho sakta hai.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Okay, Dr. Shakti.
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah. It was very good and very. No issue, ma'am. It's a very wonderful presentation, and I hope you will get so nice information regarding the food products and how we have to take food. Hope. Almost all the participants get knowledge about this. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sakti.
Any question from the... thank you, ma'am. Any question from participants?
Mujhe lagta hai sab thak gaye.
You want to... No, ma'am. Any questions?
Okay, no problem. Abhi nahi to kabhi in future also, if you have any query, you are most welcome anytime. My contact detail are with Dr. Shakti. Anytime personally, if you want to from B Bappa Reddy, about the ideal. कहाँ गए क्वेश्चन आइडियल कैलोरी हाँ आइडियल कैलोरी यस वेरी गुड सो दिस वन आइडियल कैलोरी सो हाउ मच कैलोरी वी हैव टू डू कैलोरी मीन्स द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी आई मीन व्हिच वी आर टेकिंग इट्स सो दिस हाउ मच कैलोरी दिस इज नॉट आई मीन दिस विल डिफर फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन से फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर अ किड the amount of calorie intake will be different for the adult. The amount of calorie intake required will be different, and even under within the adult also we have different group with different lifestyle, some with the sedentary lifestyle, someone with a very active lifestyle like the athletes. So बहुत सारे athletes होंगे like Dr. Deepti Joshi who will be our guest tomorrow, which is one of my good best friend. Then many more. Yeah. So I mean, so for the defense personnel, their requirement will be different. So in this way, how the calorie requirement will be differ from person to person, and all these things these are all the requirements for every group. It is all documented. We can get it this thing. So for calorie intake, it mainly concerned with the type of the food we are taking, like how much is the fat content we are taking, how much is the carbohydrate content we are taking, how much is the protein content we are taking, because in all these component, nutritional components, they are required by our body. We cannot ignore fat. It has specific role in our body metabolism. Protein has different function in our body. Carbohydrate has different function. We cannot ignore. But what is the correct amount? That is most important. So to decide the correct amount based on our body system, based on our lifestyle, we need to consult with our dietitian, with the nutritionist, because they are the expert. So in this way, in today's world, we should take health as our priority. Life is very precious. ये पोस्ट नौकरी पैसा इट हैज सम वैल्यू बट इट हैज नो मीनिंग टू रन आफ्टर दिस. इंस्टेड वी शुड फोकस ऑन आवर हेल्थ, वी शुड फोकस ऑन आवर लाइफ. वी शुड वैल्यू आवर लाइफ, वी शुड वैल्यू आवर हेल्थ. दिस इज द की मंत्र ऑफ अ गुड लिविंग. सो दिस आई मीन 5 days faculty development program with the theme that of healthy foods for healthy society. So I really appreciate it. This is the need of the hour. Life is very uncertain. Pata nahi kab who what will happen in the next moment. Kisi ke saath, I pray to God ki sab healthy rahe. So we need to focus more on our health, on our family. So that is why I feel very privileged to be a part of this event. Mujhe bhi, I'm learning is a never ending process. I'm a teacher, but still I'm learning, because I'm still a student. Agar sense mein dekha jaye, because learning is a never ending process. I keep on learning. So whatever I know, whatever I have learned and my experiences, today I have shared with the audience here on this platform. So I really thank the organizing committee, the department, the faculties, and the university, SES University in Indore, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you so much, one and all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes,
Doctor. Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so much, ma'am, for over here, for inviting our accept our invitation for the same, ma'am. We are very fortunate today, and everyone fortunate today for your allowance for the very good knowledge and wonderful presentation you have given to us. So thank you so much, ma'am. And in future, you have to come for us and brief note yes. the full day.
Yes, definitely, definitely. I will be more happy. So, and I feel so privileged and honored that you invited me. I mean, the organizing committee invited me for this event. I really feel honored. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.
Can we leave, Dr. Shakti?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am. Sure. Please.
Thank you, everyone. Stay safe. Stay healthy.
Thanks, ma'am. Thanks a lot.